What's going on, everybody? It's Eric Rayweather back here with the latest Madden 21 news. We've got a small little update to go over. We had some new things added to the game today, and then I'm going to go over the huge roster update that was just put in the game. Really big roster update. A lot of players went up this week, but there's also a lot of players going down. So make sure to let me know in the comments, as always, who is getting disrespected in the ratings, who's getting dropped that shouldn't be dropped, and who's not getting an increase that deserves an increase. Now, if you're new to the channel and you always want to be up to date on the latest Madden news and tips and updates, make sure to subscribe. Turn on the bell icon so that you never miss any of these important uploads when they go live. So first off, I want to talk about a quick little title update that came out yesterday. It was a hot fix to address a bug. So if you remember, a couple days ago, we got a huge title update, the biggest one so far yet this year. I'll link that video below in the pinned comment if you haven't seen it yet, if you want to get caught up. But in that update, there was something that was broken. Surprise. Receivers are dropping wide open passes, and it was making the game unplayable. They went in and they hot fixed it. They fixed the issue, so I'm not exactly sure how serious the issue was, because they were able to get in there and fix it quick. They obviously didn't have to change around any code or anything like that, because anytime you change around code, you have to submit the update to Sony and Microsoft for approval, and that's why a lot of times we have to deal with these bugs for weeks, because they have to get approved. So this was something maybe server-side they were able to go in and fix, luckily, so that has now been addressed. Also today, some new stuff. Series 2 officially kicked off for Ultimate Team if you are an Ultimate Team player, meaning the level cap is increased, there's new rewards and stuff to grind for, and some new content in the game. So Series 2 officially underway. And then lastly, for the yard, there's been some new gear added to the game. They did a collaboration with, I guess, some designer. Excuse me, I don't remember what his name was. I'll have some of the footage up on screen. But a bunch of new, like, colorful gear has been added to the game. So if you're a yard player, some new stuff there to go check out. Now we're going to get into the big roster update, which is the main reason why you're here. We're going to get into it in just a second, but really quickly, let's hear a word from today's video sponsor. Today's video is sponsored by HelloFresh. No matter what's going on in the world, everyone's got to eat, and HelloFresh makes that process much easier. My favorite thing about HelloFresh is just how delicious the recipes are. And not only is the food good, but they have a ton to choose from, something for everybody. Today, I'm going to be whipping up the Herbie chicken over lemony spaghetti. Now, HelloFresh also saves you a ton of time, because there's no shopping, there's no stressful meal planning. They got it all covered for you. And the best part to me is just how easy these meals are to cook. I haven't really cooked much in my life, but these meals come with very simple instructions that literally anybody can follow. HelloFresh is also very flexible to fit your lifestyle. You want to add more lunches or dinners to your weekly order, or you want to skip a week because you're not in need, maybe. You know, they make all that extremely simple for you. Now, use my code RayWeather80 to get $80 off, including free shipping on your first box with purchase. Go to HelloFresh.com to redeem and for more details. Okay, so first we're going to cover the blog where EA goes in depth about a few players that they put up and put down and why, and then we'll just cover like all of the big names that went up and went down after that. So for the week 2 risers, the first guy they're talking about is Josh Allen for the Bills, going up +1 with 78. It says, Josh Allen did it all, and he did it all extremely well in week 2. The big Bills quarterback threw for 417 yards, 4 touchdown passes, and a win against the Dolphins. His awareness and ball carry vision ratings were lifted following his performance of week 1. Now he's due for another ratings bump, especially to his trucking and his deep accuracy after he used his 6'5" frame to steamroll a couple of large men on the Dolphins defense and completed a beautiful deep ball to Stephon Diggs for a touchdown. So Josh Allen going up. Some would probably say he's still a little bit too underrated. DK Metcalf, the next guy they're going into, he's just been killing it. It says that he's going up +1 to 80. In front of a national audience on Sunday Night Football, DK Metcalf was shadowed by Pro Bowl corner and Madden 99 club member Stephon Gilmore. Metcalf won, and nobody wins against Gilmore. The second-year Seahawks player posted 4 catches, 92 yards, and 1 touchdown, and his touchdown came on a 54-yard bomb from Russell Wilson. What's most impressive is it was the first touchdown reception Gilmore has given up in coverage over the last 2 seasons per Next Gen Stats. And then the last guy they're talking about here is Mike Gesicki, going up +2 to 81. It's finally kind of clicking, and he's tearing up being the guy that they drafted him to be. It says the Dolphins need literally anything to fire them up on offense at this point, and Mike Gesicki was that guy in week 2. Posted a career day, racked up 8 catches for 130 yards and a score and a loss against the Bills. He's big, he's fast, and he's been getting open as Miami has unlocked his full potential out of the slot, which poses crazy matchup problems for opposing defenses. So he's on the upswing this week. Now let's talk about the guys that are going down that they want to talk about. And the first one is Drew Brees, going down 3 to a 90 overall. Now, I'm a Saints fan. I'll be the first to admit, Drew Brees is washed. He's still a decent QB, but he's washed, right? Going down three seems a bit excessive, though, and I'm going to go over a little bit more why a little bit later in the video. But it says here, maybe it was not having star receiver Michael Thomas at his disposal due to injury, but Breeze did not have much success against the Raiders in week two. The veteran QB threw for 312 yards with one touchdown and one interception. Now 41 years old, Breeze has struggled to throw the ball downfield thus far this season, and his Madden ratings will be toned down because of it. The next guy is Carson Wentz, another guy kind of struggling to start the year, going down 1-82. But Carson Wentz is another example of, like, I said this last week, he's a guy that could put together a few good weeks and they won't put him up. But every single time he has a bad week, it seems like they put him down. It seems like they kind of play favorites sometimes. I don't know. It's just what it seems like. Some players, they judge a little bit more harshly, it feels like. I know as a Saints fan, it's just, and we're rated really well on the game as a team, don't get me wrong, but I've always noticed, like, if the Saints have a bad week, they drop, like, multiple players on the team, it seems like, but they could have, like, a 5-game win streak, and they don't get much boost, and maybe it's because they're already rated highly, but just little things like that that I've noticed. You notice things from your own team a little bit more than you notice them from other teams, but either way, it says here, it's been a rough start for Carson Wentz, who now has 4 interceptions through 2 games. He failed to throw a touchdown pass in week 2 against the Rams and has yet to throw for more than 270 yards in a game. To his credit, Wentz doesn't have great receivers to throw to, but he needs to be more efficient if he wants to get the Eagles out of the 0-2 start. And lastly here, they touch on T.Y. Hilton going down 1-86. Says he's been known to ghost once in a while, but this is getting ridiculous. T.Y. Hilton has just 7 receptions for 81 yards through 2 games. It's not an issue of separation or Phillip Rivers not seeing him open. Hilton dropped what would have been a 44-yard touchdown pass against the Vikings last week, but the Colts coach said he lost the ball in the sun, which is legit. Still, it's not a good look for Hilton, who will see his Madden rating drop this week due to an underwhelming start. So now let's get into all the players going up and getting down. There's a lot going up, so I'm going to go over some of these guys in particular, and then I'll just kind of put a list up on the screen because there's so many people going up this week. Myles Garrett, plus 1194. Nick Chubb killed it last week. He's becoming one of the best running backs in the league, plus 2-193. Stephon Diggs, plus 1-193. Aaron Rodgers, plus 2-192. I believe he started the year at 89. People were not happy about that. It was a little underrated, and he's showing that he still has it, so he's plus 2 to that 92. He's tearing it up. Cameron Hayward, plus 2-192. Jair Alexander, plus 1-191. Josh Jacobs also killing it, plus 1-91. Odell Beckham, plus 1-91. You notice, like, last week they dropped him, this week they go up. They do that with a lot of players. Like, they'll drop him 1 week, they go up the next week, then they'll drop him the next week. It's like, maybe you should wait at least a couple weeks to see, like, is something consistently good or bad before just going up, down, up, down, up, down. Because it's like, sometimes I feel like they're just too... they're too weak to weak with some of these guys. Now, Brady's going up plus 1-191, and this is what kind of threw me off a little bit, because Breeze gets dropped so much, but Brady goes up, and they've both looked pretty washed to start the year. I mean, I guess I'll concede, I think Breeze is maybe a little more washed than Brady, just because Brady can get the ball down the field a little more consistently, so maybe this is like a thing where they're overcorrecting, that maybe they had Breeze rated a little bit too high. But it just feels weird that if you look at what they've both done to start the season, Breeze has still had a better start to the season. Maybe been a little bit more inaccurate, which is kind of crazy to say for Drew Breeze. But, and let me be clear, statistics are not everything. You know, you got to look at the advanced stuff as well. But if you just look at how they've started the year, it seems like, you know, Brady isn't having a better start to the year than Breeze really is. So to have one go down 3 and then the other guy go up 1 just kind of seems off. Because if anything, if you want to just drop Breeze down and say, hey, he's going to be a 90 and so is Brady, okay, whatever, I'm not really going to argue. But to put one up when he's not really doing any better, I don't know, that kind of throws it off. And it's like, people just want consistency with the ratings, and sometimes it feels like there's just not consistency there, and we're not even really sure why certain players are moving one way and then the other player who's pretty much playing the same is moving in the opposite direction. Here's the rest of the players that are going up. I'm just going to put them up on the screen here because there's just so many players. Some guys to note here for sure, you know, Nick Bosa going up, but he, you know, ACL injury, so speedy recovery. TJ Watt going up again. He came in underrated. Everybody knew it. He's going to probably keep going up every week as he proves that he deserves to be in those 90s. Darren Waller, who just completely destroyed my team, plus 1-86. He probably should have went up higher because he just destroyed things. Harrison Butker, plus 3-85. I mean, he hit so many 50-yarders last week. It's ridiculous. He deserves every bit of that. Raheem Mostert, somebody I wanted to talk about, plus 1-85, but his speed goes up plus 2-97. His excel is plus 2-96. Now he's one of the absolute fastest guys in the game, the for sure fastest running back. Those speed increases don't happen very often. And here's just some other guys here. Cam Newton plus 1 to 80. Now he's getting back into that 80 club, showing that he still has it, which was very good. Now let's talk about the players that are going down. So we have Julio Jones. He had a big drop last week, but he was injured as well. Something to keep note of, but he's minus 1 to 196. Mitchell Schwartz down 1 to 195. Chandler Jones down 1 to 194. Rob Gronkowski also looking very washed, down 2 to 89. Demario Davis down 1 to 88. And I mean, again, as a Saints fan, don't get that. He's the only player that did a good job covering Darren Waller. The only one. If anything, Malcolm Jenkins should have got dropped, and he didn't get touched at all. Like I said, I just want consistency. Malcolm Jenkins got torched in coverage all night. He got trucked multiple times. His rating doesn't drop. Demario Davis, who actually played very well in coverage on the one guy that no one on the rest of the team could defend, and he goes down. Doesn't really make sense. AJ Green down 1 to 87. I hate to see that. He's one of my favorite players, but he's looking kind of washed as well. DeMarcus Lawrence down 2 to 87. Patrick Peterson down 1 to 87. Zadarius Smith down 1 to 87. Deshaun Watson down 1 to 85. Again, Watson, one of those guys, I mentioned it earlier. Bad week, drop him. But if he has a couple good weeks, seems like he has to have 3 good weeks to go up, but 1 bad week, he goes down. Again, just kind of feels like they play favorites with some of these guys. Emmanuel Sanders down 2 to 85. He's definitely not looked good to start the year. Greg Olsen minus 1 to 85. Ndamukong Suh minus 1 to 85. Josh Lambeau down 1 to 84. Alshon Jeffrey down 1 to 83. Eric Ebron down 1 to 83. Ryan Kerrigan down 1 to 83. Damian Williams down 1 to 82. Another one of these things that doesn't make sense. He has not played it down this year. He opted out. How do you drop players? They did this last year. How do you drop players who aren't playing? Like, their ability to be a good player or to live up to their rating can't be docked if they're not playing, especially for a reason like as serious as just opting out because of the situation. Doesn't really make sense. Frank Clark down 1 to 82. Michael Brockers down 1 to 82. Orlando Brown down 1 to 82. Tevin Coleman down 1 to 82. Leonard Fournette down 1 to 81. See, like, again, something that doesn't make sense. He had a good week. And you could say, well, most of his production came on that one big touchdown run. Well, who cares? Like, sometimes that's what it is as a running back. You might not have the best game, but you break off a big one. You know, Adrian Peterson throughout his career, not comparing Fournette to Adrian Peterson, but Adrian Peterson had many games in his career where he was just stifled most of the game, but he broke off the one or two big ones in the game that made up for his entire stat sheet and helped his team. Sometimes that's what being a running back is. I'm not saying you had to make Leonard Fournette go up, but a guy that put up 100 yards and 2 touchdowns on like 13 carries, I just don't see a justification for dropping someone after that performance. Like, that just will never make sense to me. And here's some of the rest of the guys up on screen that went down. Kirk Cousins, horrible week, down 2 to 80. These are just the rest of the guys, throwing them up on the screen just so we can speed through this video and not waste that much more of your time. But that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it informative. If you did, as always, like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys next time.